last game for episode 4 is GoldenEye 007 on the Nintendo 64. While I've owned this game nearly 15 years and played it on and off nearly 20, I've never actually beaten this game. Main reason is due to not being very into first-person games in general, second reason is that this game is hard. I played this game long before I saw the film, which was the first Bond film I'd seen all the way through. I enjoyed it. I haven't seen very many Bond films though. I've seen at least some of all of Brosnan's, one of Dalton's, I can't remember, Octopussy, and Never Say Never Again. Maybe another more one, but I'm not sure. Bond's always been on the maybe one day list. Ignore that 007 save file, it was on my copy when I got it. So I start a new game on Agent difficulty because I'm fully aware of my own skill level on this game. First level is Verdun, where the only objective is to bungee jump from the platform to get into the secret Soviet chemical warfare facility. There's also breathing from M, Q and Money Penny to read if you want. First thing, Rare did a good job expanding really short scenes from the film into full levels without it feeling forced. In the film, this is just Bond bungee jumping off the dam. Yeah, I bought the film on DVD just for this video. It was to make sure I got all these Russian names pronounced right, and seeing the film all the way through for the first time in nearly 20 years was a bonus. You might be wondering why buy the film when I could just YouTube scenes to figure out how they're pronounced. Well, I didn't think of that until right now as I'm writing this, shut up. Second thing is that the game recording came out very dark, and I apologise. My Elgato doesn't like my Nintendo made composite cables, it seems, as some things recorded on my N64, GameCube and Wii came out that way. You may have noticed it a little in the Rocky video. You did watch it, didn't you? Not Super Nintendo though, strangely enough, even though I used the exact same cable for it at the N64 and GameCube. This is going to be a thing sadly until episode 7 where I finally discover that the Elgato has its own brightness settings, so please bear with me. Unless I figure something out while editing, in which case this paragraph I've written was a waste of time. So while I was jabbering, I killed a couple guys and got the KF-7 Soviet and climbed some stairs to get the sniper rifle. It doesn't zoom in as much as you'd expect, but it gets the job done. You can also whack people with the end of it. May as well get it out of the way and talk about the gameplay, or more specifically, has this game aged well? Now, bear in mind my general experience with FPSs. Off the top of my head, I believe I've only beaten 4. The first and third Metroid Prime games, the first Red Steel, and Zombie U. So, 2 well-regarded, 1 mixed, and 1 not so well-regarded. Obviously they're not the only ones I've played, just beaten. But in my experience playing this game 22 years after release, I think it's aged fine. Yes, it doesn't use 2 sticks and the N64 controller isn't going to be as precise as a mouse, but they knew that developing this and build a game around it. Bond has a decent auto aim, and the enemy AI was made easy enough to deal with using this control scheme. Obviously I can't talk about where it lands in the pantheon of first person shooters since 1, it's the first one I've done for this show, the super spy barely qualifies, and 2, I don't have much experience with the genre. Last time I properly played an FPS was 5 years ago. But the game. Nothing much happened in that time, I went for a tunnel and killed some dudes. I picked up my first body armour, basically a second health bar but explosions bypass it. I make my way through a pair of security gates and clear out this next area, use the manual aiming to shoot off its lock to get through the gate. I then strafe along the dam with the C buttons as it's a lot faster than walking normally until I get to the end and bungee jump off the dam without a bungee. Nice simple level to ease you into the game. Next is the facility, or the future bane of my life, but that's much later. 4 objectives, gain entry to laboratory area, rendezvous with 006, destroy all tanks in the boiling room and minimise scientists' casualties. We start off crawling through the vents and killing the guy standing in front of the toilet but refusing to use it. Drop down and kill the guy standing in front of the urinal and refusing to use that. Leave the bathroom, go down the stairs, get the armour and make my way across the rooms clearing up the soldiers until I find the clearance B keycard. With it I can get into this room and use the panel to open the security door so I can get through and slot of a locker room. Through the next corridor, ignoring the other rooms as they're not important on Agent. Clear out these two and open the security doors leading to the laboratory and that's objective A complete. Go up the stairs and take out the soldiers. Can't kill too many scientists, although I'm certain I remember Sean Bean doing exactly that in the film. I should have killed a couple though, considering what this area is going to do to me in a later episode. I go through one more door and meet up with 006, Alec Trevelyan, who takes his time noticing I'm here. While the two chat, I plant the remote mines on the tanks. The alarm goes off and Trevelyan is held at gunpoint by General Arkady Orumov. I blow up the tanks and escape, leaving Trevelyan to die. Third level is the runway. Just gotta find the plane ignition key and escape in the plane. This is gonna be a very quick one. Open the shutter, go in this first building, kill the guys and pick up the key. Then the computer exploded and I don't know why. Strafe over to the other side, get in the tank, drive it down the runway to the plane and take off. This level had a target time of 5 minutes and I beat it in 1 minute 13 seconds, unlocking a cheat, the DK mode. I won't be using them as I'm completing the game, obviously. Fourth level is the Severnaya surface. I've got to power down the communications dish and enter the hidden base for a ventilation tower. 5 of the next 6 levels are original to the game. We're still 4 years out from the present day in the game, whereas after the runway sequence in the film, it gets right to present day. In the film, Bond is never here, he only views his place by satellite. When I was a kid, I didn't realise the enemies in this level were wrapped up with the cold because I didn't know anything about Siberia. I'd never even heard of it when I was 6, so I thought they were robots. I still remember the route for this level years later, so I dash right to the satellite dish, run up the stairs and shut it down. After that I run through this ventilation tower, climb up the ladder, shoot off the locks and jump in. Next is the bunker, where I have to copy the GoldenEye key and leave the original, and photograph the main video screen. Right away I spend too long trying to shoot a security camera so I get spotted and the alarm goes off. This is another location we see in the film but Bond never visits. It's where Natalia Simeonova and Boris Grishenko work before Arumov's men come in and kill everyone. This is a really small level and I can kill everyone quickly. I scare off Boris, pick up the GoldenEye key without realising and go into the pause menu to equip the camera and photograph the screen. I copy the key and throw it away and then leave. That's a quarter of agent difficulty done already. Level 6, the silo, is one I only have vague memories of. All I have to do here is photograph the satellite and don't kill too many scientists. They've been using missile test firings to mask the launching of the GoldenEye satellite. This level's quite a bit longer than what came before. This is also the first completely original location in the game too. There's no missile silo in the film. The pan for this level and agent goes corridor, remove scientists where I have to scare a keycard off one, more corridors, repeat. Sometimes we'll pass a missile. In the fourth room containing scientists, I find a satellite and take the photo, completing objective A. Through the next door is a room over with some more soldiers. I just stand in the doorway gunning everyone down. If you shoot him enough you can pick up his briefcase, but it has no use. Going down everyone in the computer room and exit using the lift. This level had a 3-minute target but I spent a lot of time messing around in it so I'll have to come back for the cheat later. Level 7 is the frigate, where I have to rescue hostages and plant a tracking bug on a helicopter. We're actually in the present day now. This is sorta in the film. Bond is on a boat where a helicopter is stolen by people working for a Janus, and the inside of the frigate looks like the boat in the film, but it wasn't the hostage situation. They just kill the pilots and take off with the helicopter. I free one hostage, but one in the next room is shot dead before I realise they were even in the next room. The hostage I did free likes to hang around in front of me while I'm being shot at. I make my way further down into the ship and keep killing all the enemies and freeing hostages until enough escape to complete objective A. I don't know the exact amount needed to pass or how many need to die to fail an agent, but I think I saved all but the one I'd lost earlier and this last one here because I didn't realise he had a guy stood behind him. After that, I get lost for a bit trying to find the side of the ship with the helicopter, but when I do, I throw the tracking bug on it and leave. For level 8, the helicopter was tracked back to the 7 layer surface where I have to break the communications link to the bunker and then get inside. I always remember this level for the blood red sky and also the fact that I get stuck here a lot. This time they're aware and I have them coming for me almost right away. Gotta say though, this level is probably one of the ones affected by the dark recording the most, as you can see. Unless of course I figured out a good fix, which I probably didn't. I go back to the satellite dish to shut it down again, but the door's locked. I then throw my one remote mine onto the dish itself, which causes the game to tell me, "You did it wrong, knobhead." Ever constantly make the same mistake every time you play a certain game because you remember the act of doing the wrong thing, but don't remember it actually being the wrong thing? Let's try again. I find a stolen helicopter and throw the mine at it, the game letting me know I did it right. Then I realised that blowing up the helicopter was most likely an objective for a higher difficulty and I didn't need to restart the level. I said I got stuck here a lot, mainly because a lot of the landscape looks the same. Also the red sky is cool but it does make the level a little darker, making it a bit harder to figure out where exactly I am. So there's a few minutes of wandering around checking out every cabin, probably checking the same cabin multiple times and not knowing. After a ludicrous amount of time and two more aborts, I find the communications room key after killing this guard. With it I can open the door, destroy the communications link and enter the bunker where of course I get caught because I walk right in through the front door. After that I'm back in the bunker where my objectives are to recover a CCTV tape and escape with Natalia. Spoilers. So yeah, we're in a cell with no weapons and next to us is Natalia Simeonova. She's accused of being a traitor to the country while Arumov stole the GoldenEye. Once again, Bond was never here in the film and he meets Natalia later, the actual meeting being less polite than what we're seeing here. To get out I have to equip the watch magnet attract and wait for the guard to pass by me to use it, swiping the cell key. I get out and Judo chop the jailer to death and use the watch magnet over this grate to pick up some throwing knives. I also pick up the guard's KF-7 Soviet and free Natalia. I remember really struggling with this level back as a kid and I don't think I ever actually beat it. I just remember the drones in the ceiling wiping me out, or Natalia walking in front of my gunfire. Yeah, like that. Next time I leave Natalia in a cell while I deal with everyone else. After clearing out the bottom level I go upstairs and find the CCTV tape near where I started the first bunker level. I go back and free Natalia and make a dash for the exit. Sadly I get killed on the way. Next time I free Natalia since I know where the tape is and make a run for it. I just take the hits and run out with her. I see I miss a target time by 6 seconds so I give it another go. This time Natalia decides to check on the computer which prevents me from leaving so I abort and try again. Next time after I pick up the tape Natalia casually walks to my gunfire again and dies. Nothing goes wrong the next time though and I beat the level in 1 minute 6 seconds and unlock the double throwing knives cheat. Level 10 is the St. Petersburg Statue Park where I have 5 objectives. Contact Valentin Zhukovsky, finally meet Janus, find the helicopter, rescue Natalia, apparently she's gone missing, and find the flight recorder. Holy shit, this level is dark. Watching the recording I can barely see what's going on. While I make my way through the level to find Valentin, the guards are shooting at me. This stage I remembered as one of the few after the first 5 that I could actually beat. I also remembered it for the music which stands out compared to the rest of the soundtrack. Most of the rest are actiony but this one has a more downbeat feel to it. Eventually I find Valentin, who tells me Yanis will meet me at Lenin's statue and that he's Alien's Cossack. If you haven't seen the film or played the game and don't know who they are, look it up. After continuing further and finding the statue, I wait and put my gun away. Yanis and his men turn up and he turns out to be Trevelyan. He states his plan to get revenge on the British government for Lien's Cossacks. He's after Tali with the stolen helicopter at the park gates. He also has the GoldenEye firing key and has rigged the helicopter to blow up in 3 minutes. Now I can kill Alec's goons and take their automatic shotguns. I like this gun, it just wipes out anyone picking a fight with me here. So this is where Bond and Natalia actually meet in the film. Bond gets hit with a tranq dart and wakes up in the exploding helicopter with her screaming at him. As long as you remember the way back, you have plenty of time. Natalia's just left snoozing beside the helicopter and getting close thanks to the proximity fuse, leaving you 15 seconds to get her away from the explosion. Easy, although there will be the odd time where she'll just stand there and wait for a fiery death. With the helicopter exploded, all the Yanis guys I ignored on the way back catch up and shoot at me. They miss a few shots and kill Natalia. Gotta try again. With how long the later difficulties of this level took, I just wonder how much time I've spent staring at Robbie Coltrane's face. Next time I save Natalia, I run away from her to get her out of the enemy's firing range. The flight recorder isn't far away, and as I return to the gates, me and Natalia are arrested by Defense Minister Dmitry Mishkin. I'm blamed for shooting guards and blowing up the helicopter. Hey. Only the worst of those two things I did. He wants to question us on Severnaya, and we get marched to the military intelligence HQ. That's the first half of Agent done. Next is the archives, where I have to escape the interrogation room, find Natalia, and then escape with her. These interrogators aren't very smart. They left the gun on the table in front of me and stood on the opposite side of the room, so they get killed. They drop the DD44 dust over here, which despite picking up in quite a few levels now, I'm only just using. I also pick up the door key. It doesn't matter though, since the guard swings the door right open to shoot me. I leave the room and stand by the stairs until said stairs get bored of sending guards down to me. This level's kind of a maze, it's a lot of smaller rooms I have to navigate to find Natalia. I go up the stairs and start clearing out all these similar looking corridors. When I kill the first guard in the level's biggest room, I find I can now hold double dust of theirs. I like this. After emptying the rooms with all the bookshelves in them, I somehow miss the one door leading to Natalia and go downstairs instead. I run into Mishkin, who tells Bond he was right about Urimov being a traitor. He gives me the safe key so I can get the helicopter's black box. Thing is, I don't need an agent, so I kill him. I mean, he dies in the film anyway, and I don't get punished for it as long as he dies after giving me that key. Of course, in the film it's Urimov that kills him, but since he didn't, I had to be the brave one to murder a man to save canon. By this point, just about everyone else is dead, so I'm free to wander around and find Natalia at my own pace. I find my way outside and kill everyone there too, figuring this is where I'm supposed to escape. Yeah, this isn't one of those levels I didn't beat as a kid. The save I'd used had all but the secret levels unlocked, so I just keep trying them out of order. 13 embarrassing minutes into this level, and I finally find Natalia and free her. I figure out I'm supposed to shoot this window and escape through, but guess who got caught on some scenery or something and got left behind without me realising. I like Natalia well enough in the film, not so much in this game. So I do all that again and make sure Natalia's right next to me as I escape. We stop to pause and in that time she's taken by Urimov off screen for level 12, the streets of St. Petersburg. All I have to do is pursue Urimov and not kill too many civilians. This level drove me mad as a kid. I never beat it because of the briefing. It says Natalia is being taken by car, and there's a timer in this level. So I spend all my time looking for a moving cart until I'd either run out of time or die. So right away I get in the tank, and the other reason I'd fail this level would happen. At 6, I didn't know what the words minimise and civilian meant, and casualty just meant that's what my grandmother would watch after the lorry with the theme tune I liked. So I'd see them, crush them under the tank, and wonder why I kept failing the level. If it looks like I'm drunk driving the tank, it's because I'm applying the strafing lets me walk faster strategy to the tank. Eventually I have to abandon the tank and just run the rest of the way, hoping I'm not getting lost in the streets and retracing my steps. Also hope I don't accidentally step on the landmines. I already drove over a few of the tank and lost quite a bit of health. Somehow I managed to make all the right turns and I start to get very worried as I see the end of the level in front of me but end up with an empty life bar. I make it, but for those 5 or so seconds I was terrified. The level had a target of 1 minute 45 seconds. Not now, I'll come back to that one later. Next is a depot where all I have to do is locate and board Trevelyan's train. I actually beat this one as a kid, so if I struggle here I'll never be able to let go of the shame. So as I make my way through this disused train yard, I accidentally pick up some body armour while dodging enemy fire. I also pick up a D5K Deutscher from an enemy, very useful. I also keep checking out behind a couple shutters even though it's not required at all on Agent and I can just run right to the end. While I'm wasting time, I'd just like to say that the game's soundtrack is great. I already talked a bit about the statue theme, but just about every single track is great. I'd say it's one of Grant Kirkhope's best, but almost every single Grant Kirkhope soundtrack I've heard I could say is one of his best. I do know it has a lot of references to the songs of older Bond films sprinkled throughout, but that's lost on me sadly due to how little I've watched. I enter this building at the end of the depot where the door to the train is locked, so I just go upstairs, through another door, down the stairs, through a shutter and run right into the train, letting cutscene Bond deal with the last enemy. I appreciate this being an easy level, sandwiched between two I had trouble with back then. Speaking of, one I have a personal beef with, the train. I just have memories of trying this one for hours but never beating it. I think I did eventually beat it once, now it's about 15 or something, but I'm not sure. I've got to destroy the brake units, rescue Natalia, and escape to safety. This level's layout is a lot more straightforward than the last few. I'm just shooting my way from carriage to carriage, making sure to destroy these brake units along the way. The first two carriages are cargo, and we have a lot of guys hiding behind boxes. All the wooden boxes are explosive though, so you don't want to hang behind them yourself too much. Once we're out of that, it's into the passenger carriages. Thanks to the narrow space, it's easy to just gun everyone down, but there's always the guys hidden in one of the first cabins who come out as you get further in and shoot you in the back. It's one of those things where you think you'll catch them this time, but they always get the first shot in. Second passenger cabbage is loads easier. Now as we get closer to the front, there are less enemies per room, but they're more hidden. There always tends to be one off to the side of the entrance ready to shoot you the second you walk in. Gotta be careful in carriage 6, as getting to the door sets off a guy coming out of hiding in a previous locked door and shooting you from behind. That guy causes me a lot of trouble in later difficulties. After that, things are a lot simpler. I shoot the last brake unit, stop the train, and get the door key for the front of the train from the last enemy. Trevelyan and Xenia on the top are in the back, and Urumov has Natalia at gunpoint. I only have time for one shot, so I have to kill Urumov and let Trevelyan and Xenia escape. I equip my watch laser and start lasering away the corner of the floor with only a minute to escape. I make it out, but still have enemies on the outside shooting at me as I run away from the exploding train. I just make it with the tiniest bit of remaining health while the train explodes. I know it's the easiest difficulty, but I really am proud that I beat Street and Train on my first try. Now it's time for level 15, the jungle in Cuba. I have to destroy all the drone guns, kill Xenia, and escort Natalia to Viana's base. We start off with a shot of the crashed plane they used to get here. So yeah, we're stuck with Natalia throughout the entire level. Thankfully she's pretty competent in this level and can take down a few enemies for me. I run into my first drone gun and think maybe if I stand still and just trade fire with it, I'll win. Then I learn I'm wrong and just hide behind a tree while I destroy it. In the next area, instead of dealing with the drone right away since I know how dangerous they are, I just run around the outside shooting at the enemies while ending up a hit from death. Guess who doesn't beat this level on their first try? Circling around the drone gun as it's firing also isn't a smart move, but it works out for me here, for the next 15 seconds anyway. Next time I find some body armor and manage to destroy that second one, and the next one. I cross the bridge afterwards and get attacked by Xenia, who I found a nightmare back then. However, I've since found out the strategy of running back the way I came and standing off the side. Xenia can only cross the bridge and can't attack me while I'm here, which gives me the chance to shoot the hell out of her while she's crossing. Of course in the first go I missed most shots but still managed to kill her. After that is another drone to destroy followed by another as I enter this cave. The grenade launcher I picked up from Xenia deals with it easy though. I climb up the ladder, realise there's a drone waiting for me and dive back down. I fire a grenade up there and hear something getting destroyed, so I go back up and see another drone that hasn't spotted me yet and wipe that out too, completing objective A. With that, I see there's still a load of enemies guarding the end of the level so I just make a run for it. I get in the lift with Natalia and beat the level. I round up nearly 4 minutes over the target for the cheat, saving that one for another time too. Next we have Control, what I found to be one of the hardest levels in all 3 difficulties. I gotta keep Natalia from dying, disable GoldenEye, and destroy the armoured mainframes. We start off in that lift. I go ahead and clear out of a room for Natalia because she seems to have lost either her ammo or her skill. After taking out all the guards, I let Natalia out of the lift and she messes with his computer. She opens one of the two doors and I go in ahead. I then get my ass kicked right away in this next tunnel, losing about 70% of my health. But I avoid death and keep going on, up these stairs and down these while taking out more guards. In the next room is that little shit Boris, so I make things easier and kill him about 10 minutes earlier than he's supposed to die in the film. I go about the room blowing up all the mainframes I can find and open the door to let Natalia in. She thinks me killing cyber terrorist Boris wasn't very nice and runs off, refusing to stop the satellite from firing and failing the level for me. Well, fuck you too Natalia. I guess you beating the shit out of him in the film with your bare hands are trying to get you killed and also being involved in all your co-workers' deaths also isn't very nice. Not to mention if you leave him he does pull a gun on me. Having to let that weaselly fuck run off is so frustrating. His film death isn't even shown so we just have to let the man controlling the GoldenEye satellite get away with it. This time I also go into this room with the drone guns. There's a mainframe I missed last time inside. I'm gonna learn to hate those drones later. Once that mainframe is destroyed, I let Natalia in the room where she starts trying to reprogram the satellite. This is where we find out it's aimed to fire at London rather than being told by Trevelyan. Now I just have to protect Natalia from the incoming guards. This is what makes the level hard. First time I get killed without seeing a single guard. That's not usually how this goes. Next time I manage to kill a few of them but I've still not figured out all their usual locations, so they kill Natalia. I find a hidden body armor next time so at least I can survive some more shots. I hang around above and try to cut off most of the enemies before they can get in firing range. It's a bit risky though since some slip through and get some shots in. But it works this time. Natalia makes GoldenEye's orbit decay and Bond tells us to go back to the surface while he deals with Trevelyan. The other two doors in this room can now open and I find the final mainframe. With it destroyed I try to find the exit. I end up in front of it but surrounded. After blowing a few guys up and running away because I don't want to get killed entering the lift, I find another body armor that I am very thankful for. With it I run straight for the lift and finish the level. Second to last normal level now, the caverns. All I have to do is reach the end of the level without killing too many scientists. This is another area original to the game. In the film, Bond chases Trevelyan, they both end up in the area the final level is based on right away. The scientist killing is easy to avoid on Agent, since they're only in the lower levels of those areas and I don't have to go down there in Agent. I go up this big spiral and the room after it to find another room where I can just run and gun my way through. I stop at this door halfway through and go in. I see the drone, decide no thanks, and continue along the normal path. The strafe room works really well on this narrow bit. I take out both guards in front of the door while missing one of them dropping something. I run right ahead and blow up the back area, destroying the radio and preventing me from contacting Jack Wade. Doesn't matter on Agent, so I don't care. Also kill a scientist, but there aren't enough to fail the level here anyway. Pick up that body armor on the crate because I'm nearly dying, and then finish off my backlog of stalkers. I pick up a code card, but it can't open this door, so I go for a look around. I go and clear out the room with the drone and find another code card. This lets me open that door, but there's another door I can't open. After a ridiculous amount of looking, including going back to the beginning of the level to look around, I finally spot a card on the floor where I killed that guard. I'd walked past it with it being on screen many times, and there's my patented UltraKintaro's an absolute idiot moment for this game. After that it's simple, go through the doors, try fighting a drone face to face again, chase Trevelyan into the lift and finish the level. Nearly 28 minutes. That's unforgivable. Well, last main level now, the cradle. I have to destroy the control console and finish off Trevelyan. Right away I go around the back of where I start and get a much needed body armour. All I can do here is run up the walkway and shoot at the guards as they appear. Halfway up, Trevelyan activates the main console, leaving me 3 minutes to destroy it before GoldenEye realigns. Once I get to the top, I go down to the centre and go into the shed where a drone shoots at me. I destroy both of them and realise I've lost most of my health because there was a guy shooting me in the back the whole time. Once they're dealt with, I destroy the main console and complete Objective A. Now it's time to chase Trevelyan and shoot at him. He does laps across just about the entire level, responding to being riddled with bullets with insults from the film. Sadly, I don't finish him the first time as one of his guards gets me first. Second time I get lucky and manage to take out nearly all his health in one spot. He makes a run for the lower level and goes down into his hut. He drops down the ladder and I follow, but before I can turn to face him, he shoots me off the platform. Third time I get down there and shoot him off the platform. I'm treated to seeing him fall a couple more times before Bond catches onto his helicopter and leaves. I missed out on the cheat by over a minute, but just beating the level at all unlocks the Magnum cheat. Next I'm shown Bond and Natalia kissing in the jungle while the credits play followed by a character parade. This is still an enjoyable game, but I'm not done yet. There are still two levels I haven't unlocked. For them I'm going to have to do the high difficulties, so I go back to the dam and choose Secret Agent. The only objective for this one is neutralising all the alarms. On Secret Agent, enemies are not only more accurate with their shots, but they also do more damage. So I just have to shoot out all these alarms before I do the bungee jump. Thing is, I only know of this first one, and I get killed looking for the second. The others are in these buildings along the dam I ignored last time. Don't have to go in very far, they're just by the doors. There's one in all 3 buildings for a total of 4 alarms. With the last one destroyed, I can jump off the dam again. Turns out on this difficulty there's a cheat unlocked by beating it 43 seconds faster. I can do that, just gotta play better. I get it on the very next try, beating the time by just 1 second and unlocking the paintball mode cheat. So I decide to do the level on double agent difficulty right away. Now I also have to install the covert modem and intercept a data backup. Here I get killed before I make it to the first alarm. Once I go through the gate after the first alarm, I have to turn right and head to this monitor. I then have to equip the covert modem and throw it onto the monitor. Now for that data backup. Another death later, I enter this building and go down the stairs. This is where I die a lot. Ammo is a lot more scarce than Double Agent, and I'm in a cramped tunnel with a lot of enemies, so of course I die the first time in here. And the second. And many more times after. It's only after about an hour and 20 minutes I finally make it to the end of that tunnel. Where, because I was so focused on getting here, I forgot what I was actually supposed to do here and blew up the mainframes, failing that mission. It takes me over 20 minutes to get back there. This time I just walk up to them and press B to make a backup of their data. With that done, I can finish shooting up the alarms and finish the level. From the time it took to do that, I decided to just focus on Secret Agent for now, and hopefully by the time I'm done with it, I'll be good enough to do Double Agent with relatively little trouble. The only new objective in the facility is to contact Dr. Doak, a double agent posing as one of the scientists. This guy will be my biggest enemy in the future. Level goes as normal, just with more and stronger enemies. I do have to check these side areas though, as Dr. Doak is in a random location every time the level starts. Lucky for me, he was in the first room I checked. He gives me a decoder for getting into the bottling room. Yeah, no just walking in this time. Apart from that, there's not much else different, and I finish it on my first try. The only addition to runway is that I have to destroy the missile battery. So I do. That's the only difference. For the first surface level, I have to find a safe key and steal the building plans of the bunker. I also need a large key from this soldier to get into the hut that contains a safe key. I find the safe key on a desk and run to the other side of the level where I open the safe to get the bunker plans, then I end the level. I spend quite a bit of time looking for that safe key, so I miss the cheat by over 3 minutes. But now I have everything memorized, so once again I beat the time by 1 second and unlock the double grenade launcher cheat. The only addition to Bunker 1 is destroying all the security cameras. I pretty much did all that the first time. Done. Easy. Now I have a problem. There's only footage of my first failed attempt of Silo on Secret Agent. While I was playing, our electricity ran out and I lost a 3-hour recording. What was lost? Well, me being Silo, Frigate, Surface 2 and Bunker 2 on Secret Agent, and also unlocking the No Radar and multiplayer cheat by beating Frigate in under 4.5 minutes. Considering both Silo and Bunker 2 had me struggling for over an hour each, I didn't feel like recording them again. However, you will still see me complete all of any objectives when I get around to playing them on 00 Agent. So yeah, sorry. But that's a good chunk of GoldenEye 007. Look forward to me continuing Secret Agent next time.